Acharya Vinoba Bhave traveled from village to village by foot to provide landless people with land. This movement of his is known as Bhudan Andolan. Under it, landowners donated their extra land to the poor. Most of the land was donated in the 60s. Every vigilant citizen would like to know what happened to these lands. This hilly area called Sarvodaya Gram is at Bellary in Karnataka. It may be a stony and desolate area. It is one of the biggest land transfers under Bhudan movement. A school has been opened here. This school was founded by Vasudeva Acharya. 30 years ago, a local legislator had donated 100 acres of land to Vinobaji. He handed over this plot to his disciple, Vasudeva Acharya, who had given up the job of a teacher and devoted himself to the uplift of the poor. Selecting 10 poor families, he formed a cooperative society and started collective farming as seen by Gandhiji and Vinobaji. Working day and night, he changed this barren land into fertile soil. It was his dream to make this 100-acre plot an ideal village. Vasudeva Acharya says, "We got this plot from Vinobaji under Bhudan. This area was backward in every respect. Following Vinobaji's tenet, land is a gift to man from God and everyone has equal right to it. We formed Kutkal Agricultural Cooperative with 10 families. Each family was given remuneration according to its requirements." After doing collective farming for 15 years, the cooperative went into decline as the demands of the families exceeded the requirements. The main principle of collective farming is discipline, and its ignorance shown by these families caused much pain to Vasudeva Acharya. Men like Vasudeva Acharya never accept defeat. He decided to teach discipline to these people, believing that the culture of discipline can be inculcated only at a young age. He laid the foundation for a residential school with 12 students. This school now has around 500 children in the 6 to 15 years age group. The day begins here at 4 in the morning, laying stress on the adage, "A clean place mirrors a clean mind." More attention is given to cleanliness here. Every student has to do his work himself here. The idea behind this is that they shouldn't be ashamed of doing any task and function as useful citizens of society. After being through with morning chores, they are taught yogabhyas to make them mentally strong. Controlled mind and body is the sign of a good person, and the teachers of this school try to inculcate this very idea in the children. Yogabhyas is followed by breakfast. Every student has his own glass and plate. The younger children are fed and the older ones serve them. The breakfast includes milk but no tea or coffee. Every day food is prepared for 500 to 600 people. Most food grains used in the breakfast, lunch and dinner are grown here. Milk is also procured from the society's cows. the school begins. The success percentage of 10th class students is 90%, which is one of the best results in the state. The school uniform is made of khadi and the medium of instruction is Kannada. A healthy mind resides only in a healthy body. So, the school lays much stress on games. Students are also taught gardening. They grow various plants which serve the purpose of life sciences practicals. Vasudev Acharya says, when one attempts to make such a society or ashram, the main problem is of devoted social workers. And even if such workers are available, they are not hard working. Gandhiji used to clean his room and bathroom himself. But today social workers can't even wash their own clothes, not to talk of other things. Even then, there are people who work here for nominal wages. For example, take this residential medical officer. He gets only 1,000 rupees and has to treat the children as well as the villagers. Such societies survive because of people like them. The children go home once a year. Sunday is a holiday. On this day, one should watch the liveliness and zest in them. A jump into the big well freshens them up, and those who cannot swim derive pleasure out of watching others swim. For some children, Sunday is the day to go to the cave temple on the hill. The shade of dense trees freshens them up for the coming week. These activities give rise to many questions. Aren't these children drifting away from the modern competitive life? Do they know what competition means? Isn't the absence of shops an attempt to keep the children away from a modern life? This all depends on the point of view of the viewer. In fact, allowing a child to live in close proximity with nature offers him a chance of getting the best education. In this context, modern facilities are meaningless. Growing age makes one lazy and dims hope, but not with Vasudev Acharya. His attempt to make the younger generation disciplined is at its zenith today. His attempt to promote cooperation among farmers may have lagged behind. Day is not far away when there will be a surge of awareness and eagerness in farmers, which will translate Vasudev Acharya's dream of Sarvodaya to self-reliance into a reality.